Hi, North Hills. Today we are entering into the fourth week of Lent. And if you are fasting or if you have committed to a particular reflection practice, either you are doing really well, turning it into a habit, or you have quit long ago. I encourage you not to quit though. Keep going. This is not a contest. This is not, you know, a competition. This is Lent. So keep going. For the next 6 days ahead of us now, till next Tuesday, I want you to focus on one pivotal chapter in the Gospel of Mark, Mark chapter 10. Here, Jesus moves from Galilee in the north down to Judea in the south, and he is headed to Jerusalem. And we know, of course, in Jerusalem is where Jesus will be crucified on a cross and laid to rest in the tomb. And in chapter 10, Jesus wants his disciples to understand what is going to happen to him. And so he talks about it to them very plainly. You'll see he talks about the betrayal. He talks about being arrested. He talks about the suffering that's going to happen to him. The disciples, of course, don't understand anything that he is saying in this moment because they've been experiencing such great moments with Jesus, such tremendous success in the ministry with Jesus. They can't fathom that something could possibly go wrong. Jesus is clearly doing the work of God here. Now, in the one section I want you to pay very close attention to in chapter 10 are verses 35 through 45. And here in this section, two disciples who are brothers, James and John, are going to ask Jesus for a favor. And we all know when someone asks us for a favor, it's probably not going to go well. And it doesn't in this situation either. They ask Jesus, believe it or not, they ask Jesus if he will make them the greatest in the kingdom. Well, besides him. Can one of them sit on the right hand and the other sit on the left hand while Jesus, you know, sits in the center? And their request is almost laughable in this moment. But they are dead serious. They really want this. They want an anointing to be the greatest among all the disciples. And that creates a lot of problems and tension with the disciples, and Jesus has to help them sort it out. But you know, you think about recognition for doing things is a very powerful force. So powerful, in fact, that some people have actually killed for it. Some people have destroyed nations over it, destroyed companies and churches and marriages and friendships just for recognition. But I want you to pay close attention in this particular section to how Jesus responds to his disciples, because Jesus doesn't deny essentially the need for recognition. Jesus just has a very different view on what it means to be great. See how Jesus' understanding of greatness contrasts to our culture's understanding of greatness. Like, who is the true and real goat in the world, as we sometimes say? Anyway, now in chapter 10, there are six different stories. They all are very significant, so take your time going over them. Read them slowly. I also have one other thought for you. Instead of just reading Mark chapter 10, I know most of you probably read your Bible on your cell phone or from a tablet, but so you have the ability to play the audio version, the ability to have somebody actually read the scriptures to you. And I would encourage you to do that. Play the reading of the scriptures. You know, for centuries, Christians never had Bibles to look at, never had any way of actually reading the Bible themselves. And in fact, many couldn't read. So other people would read the Bible to them. And I want to encourage you to do that over the next 6 days. You know, maybe 2, 3, 4 times during this week ahead, listen to the scripture being read. Do the best you can to focus on it and to hear it being read to you. Play it over and over, maybe in one setting, if you will. And I pray as you do that, that God will bless the hearing of his word. So let me pray for you, and then I hope you have a good week making your way through Mark chapter 10. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you for your word. We thank you for the teaching and the truth that it presents to us, the guidance, the wisdom, particularly this section that we're going to focus on in this week. We pray your Holy Spirit would speak to us, that you'd be our teacher and our guide. We thank you and we pray this in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. God bless you, North Hills. We'll see you next week.